Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In the last video, I introduced you to the x2F1 Ultra Lace Engraver. In this video, let's take a look at this conveyor accessory. The conveyor is very easy to assemble. As you can see, it comes with only a manual, a screwdriver, some screws, connecting cables, and fastening pieces A and B. Before using the x2F1 Ultra conveyor, it is necessary to fix the conveyor to the x2F1 Ultra. Just take the two fastening pieces, reverse the conveyor, and fastening piece B is mounted on the back of the conveyor. Then attach fastening piece A to the center of the x2F1 Ultra base plate edge. And then slide fastening piece B into the groove of fastening piece A and screw them with screws. And then use the connecting cable connecting x2F1 Ultra and the conveyor. It is all assembly done. You can use the conveyor for batch production now. Okay, let me show you how to use conveyor batch to start batch engraving in the x2 Creation Space software. Firstly, we need to place a material symbol on the conveyor. And please remember to close the enclosure to ensure the camera works well. In the software, we need to select the Use Conveyor Batch mode. Then a pop-up will appear asking to set the simple material. All we need to do is click on Reflect, and the x2F1 Ultra camera will take a picture and display it in the software. At this point, the software pumps up the next step of design a processing object, in which we can set the engraving parameters and adjust the laser code focus. When we are ready, click on Frame Out Material. Next, the software will show a preview of the frame out material. We can move or resize the bounding box to include the simple material inside it if we think the bounding box is unreasonable, so that makes the material recognition more accurate. If you think the frame out material is no problem, just click Save and click the Process button. The software then immediately enters the Smart View program, which is re-entered for each batch of engraving. Once the Smart View is completed, the batch engraving can begin. Let's go back to the x2F1 Ultra and the conveyor, so we can place the material in batches on the conveyor before we start batch engraving. As you can see, I simulated 3 batches to batch engraving metal jewelry. Press the start button on the touch screen and batch engraving begins immediately. When the x2F1 Ultra conveyor enters the second batch of engraving, the software will re-enter the preparing for processing program, which will retake a picture of the material, recognize again the material, and intelligently fill in the pattern, and then automatically start the second batch of engraving. All these actions are completely automatic. All we need to do is keep placing the material on the conveyor belt. Once the second batch of material has been engraved, the x2f1 ultra conveyor automatically moves on to the next batch. Here you should notice that one of the materials in the second batch was skipped and could not be engraved because the reflective surface tends to interrupt the camera's ability to capture it. The solution to this problem will be given later in the video. Now we just need to put it back on the conveyor belt to be re-engraved. Thanks to the software smart fill feature, we don't need to worry about the angle of material placement when batch engraving. In this batch engraving test, I intentionally place the material at different angles to test the ability of the smart fill button. The result show that x2f1 ultra batch engrave material perfectly, no matter what angle they are placed at. In fact, as long as the material is not highly reflective and have a regular shape, there's no need to worry about the placement angle of the material. We can place the material on conveyor belt at any angle. However, there's no support for handling different shapes of materials in the same batch engraving test. Now, I will try to use two pieces of stainless steel to show you the problem that can occur when batching engraving highly reflective materials. As we have seen previously, the software is not able to accurately recognize the outline of the material due to the reflective surface of the material, which leads to skipping the engraving of it. Now, I would like to show you another problem that can occur with highly reflective materials: the inconsistent angle of the smart filling pattern. Okay, these two round pieces of stainless steel were engraved into separate batches, and the pattern was perfectly engraved. But if you look closely, the flowers are not facing the same direction. But I want the flower pattern on each piece of stainless steel to face the perforations in the stainless steel. The reason for this problem is that because the stainless steel surface is highly reflective, the camera is unable to capture the shape of the stainless steel surface, and therefore the software is unable to recognize the position of the perforations, so it is not possible to accurately fill in each pattern. The best way to solve this problem is to cover the highly reflective surface with a coat of coating that can be easily wiped away, such as I did. Or you can dab on some powder, like flour or baby talcum powder. The coated stainless steel material can be captured perfectly by the camera, so the software can recognize the location of the perforation and therefore fill the pattern accurately. As you can see, the flowers on the two different batches of stainless steel are now both facing the same direction. The x2f1 ultra conveyor cannot batch engrave black materials without some assistance. The reason for this is simple: the conveyor belt is black, and when it comes to black material, the camera is not able to distinguish between the conveyor belt and the material very well, so the software is unable to recognize the materials. Therefore, if we need to batch engrave black materials, we need to lay the black materials on something of another color, such as a piece of white paper or a piece of plywood. In my case of batch engraving black business cards, I placed the black business cards on a piece of plywood, and this method worked very well. The plywood board can be also be used as a chain for mass production. The X2F1 Ultra Conveyor also supports the large engraving areas up to 220mm by 550mm. When selecting the Conveyor large mold for engraving, the only thing to keep in mind is that the material should not be placed beyond the center line of the Conveyor.